the heavyweight champion of the world, and another Mexican trains him, which is, yes, sir. It makes us proud.
Well, you did say that you had a fight this weekend, Lindolfo Lingado over there in Linares, Mexico, right? How did that go? How did that play out?
Look, first of all, Linares, Nuevo León, and the whole state, Monterrey is a beautiful state. Monterrey is a beautiful city. Linares, you know, I didn't expect what I've seen, you know. Going to Mexico, I've been to different places in Mexico, but Linares is a very, very small town, but very clean, beautiful people, everybody very nice. It was a great experience. Mm-hmm. The event was sold out. People in Linares went crazy, with Lindolfo. He won a third round knockout, and he beat a guy that was undefeated too. The guy, if I'm not mistaken, was 12-0 with 10 knockouts.
Yeah.
So he wasn't just a guy that we chose to go out there and get a quick knockout. We wanted somebody.
Somebody to give a good show,
yeah. That's going to give us a good fight, so we could give the fans in Linares a good show. The fans in Linares, they loved it. They enjoyed a great night of boxing, but they also enjoyed that Lindolfo went there, did his job, took him out in three rounds. But it wasn't three rounds. People might think it was an easy fight, but no. The guy was swinging. The guy wanted to win. Lindolfo dropped him like three times. He kept getting up because he wanted to win. Lindolfo was just a better man and got him with good body shots and dropped him because it was body shots that dropped him and knocked him out. But the guy was game. So it wasn't like we chose just an easy opponent to go out there and look good in his hometown. We wanted to give the fans in Linares, Nuevo León, a good show, and we did, Then Chivas was the main event and also knocked his opponent out like in two or three rounds. So it was a good show for people in Linares, especially people in Nuevo León, especially the ones in Linares. They enjoyed it. First time they've ever had a big show like that with Televisa and everything. So it was good, and it looks like we're going to go back to Linares with Lindolfo before the end of the year.
So it's good because it brings more people to the city of Nuevo León.
Definitely.
And, more boxing.
It does. Boxing is huge in every place in Mexico, but they had never brought in a show like that to Linares, a small town where right now their hero, their idol is Lindolfo.
Yeah. So
they've had they mentioned something about a former professional fighter, but many years ago that people don't even remember. Right now, Lindolfo is their idol. All the kids in school, we had the wins where a lot of kids from school were there. They all loved having Lindolfo there, and Lindolfo took pictures with everybody. That's something the kids are always going to remember. They're going to remember, that's the man that went to our school. They're gonna tell their parents to take them to watch the fight. They're gonna want to wear a Lindolfo Delgado shirt. All that is big for the town.
Yeah, it's good. It's big for the town and big for the sport.
It is big.
Is that pretty much what's going on? RGB, do we have any other big fights coming up?
Right now, we don't have anything until, I believe, what is it, June 23rd?
Mm-hmm.
That's our show we're having here in San Bernardino. And then June 28th, we have Caballo fighting June 28th. Raymond Murataya and Ruben Rodriguez fighting at the Pechanga here in Temecula. Yeah. While you're fighting on the 23rd, Luis Coria and like three more guys.
So we're going to be busy for the next next month.
And then June. When the fuck does Alexis fight?
June 29th,
June 29th.
The next day,
That's right. June 29th, Alexis fights in Rhode Island, right? Shit, Rhode Island. And then July, I think July 5th, July 17th, July 28th. We have a lot of
days. We're just going to be busy all summer.
This summer's going to be busy, yeah. We're going to be busy all summer, but, We're glad things are working out with everybody. Everybody's busy. Everybody has fights. we're happy and proud that Mexico has the super heavyweight champion of the world.
There you go.
And the only two Latinos that have ever won heavyweight world titles, both last name are Ruiz.
Ruiz, that's true.
John Ruiz and Andy Ruiz, Puerto Rican. John Ruiz, he beat Holyfield years ago, and now Andy Ruiz becomes heavyweight champion of the world with three belts, beating Joshua. I don't know if it's as big as Buster Douglas beating Mike Tyson, but for us Mexicans, it is bigger because it's a Mexican that became champion. I'm very happy for Andy Ruiz, very happy for his team, Manny, Estrellita, everybody. You know, I sent Manny a message, but I'm sure he's got hundreds of messages.
Of winner,
you know, I know he's probably going to see this, so congratulations to him, to Estrellita. Andy, you know, we're proud of you guys. You know, you guys did a great job, and you guys made us proud.